In my previous example, I showed you how to find a critical value using the T table. Now I want to go ahead and use the TI-84 for those same two examples. All right, I have them sketched off to the side. You can look at my previous video if you want to see how I came up with that sketch. But for my first part, my sample size is 12 and my level of confidence is 0.95. So I'm looking for the t value that's separates 0.025 amount of area in that upper tail. So to do that, I want to go to my distribution menu, which is that second vars key. And if you have an older TI-84, you might not have the inverse t option. Okay, and if not, that's okay. You can use your T table or you can use a software package like Minitab Express. All right, so I'm going to select the inverse T. When you're given an area or a probability first, you're going to be using an inverse function to find the value along the horizontal axis. So selecting 4, it's going to ask me for the cumulative area. So this part is a little confusing. You could put in 0.025 directly, but it's going to give you the negative version of that t value. So you could use that. Just remember to make it positive when you plug it into the formula. Okay, but to get the t value directly, you need to recognize the fact that there's actually 0.975 amount of area cumulatively to the left of that upper T value. Okay, so it would be incorrect to put in 0.95, even though we're finding a 95% confidence interval for part A. The cumulative area to the left of that T value is actually 0.975. And then it's going to ask for the degrees of freedom. If our sample size is 12, our degrees of freedom is 11. And then enter at paste. And this one takes a little bit or a fraction of a second longer. I find that the TI-84 is a little slow when it works with the T distribution. All right, so rounding to 3 decimal places. You get a value of 2.201, which is the same value you got when you use the T table from your textbook. To get the critical value for a 90% confidence interval when our sample size is 5, we go back to that distribution screen. Again, select inverse T. And you need to figure out what the cumulative area is to the left of that value. So if I have a 90% confidence level, that means 0.05 amount of area is left over in the outer tails. So cumulatively to the left, I'd have 0.9 plus the 0.05 more. So there'd be a cumulative area of 0.95 the left of that upper T value. And the degrees of freedom would be 4 if our sample size is 5. Down arrow, paste, and press enter. And enter again. And rounding to 3 decimal places, you get a T value of 2.132, and that is the same value I got in my previous example when we use the T table.